Hello, everybody. My name is Invicta, and welcome back to Monster Train here on the channel. Thank you, everybody, for the support on the Monster Train series thus far. Now, a couple of things have happened since the last time that you all saw a video here on YouTube. First off, I've beaten Covenant 12 and gone on to 13. Sorry about that. I did it on my own time, and it was with a crazy deck that I wasn't recording. And secondly, I also beat Covenant 13. So, I will admit, it was with the Stygian and Awoken banner, or clans, I should say. Both of them involved spell weakness and frostbite. So, yeah, but I am now on Covenant rank 14, going for 15 now. So, just to get you caught up on what the other Covenants are, Covenant 12, of course, major bosses have their health increased. Covenant 13, after I unlocked that, we add a copy of the primary clan starter card to our deck, which means that we just get an extra card at the beginning. And then finally, 14 minor bosses now have increased HP as well. The minor bosses are the bosses that you see on the first, third, and fifth floor of the run. So it doesn't include like Daedalus, it doesn't include Seraph or Fel. It's the minor bosses. So, and so far, it doesn't seem like they have a lot of extra HP. But since we're going all random, because we're still doing all random week here, who knows? So thank you all very much. And again, apologies, I wasn't recording either one of those. I beat both of them almost consecutively, and it was crazy. As you can see here, I stopped myself because I didn't want you guys and gals on YouTube to miss too much. So sorry. I like Monster Train. I like playing it. It's my chill out game before I go to bed. So here we go. Who are we going to get this time around? Let's find out. We got Melting Remnant and Heckhorned. Also, we got Seraph the Diligent, which means that we're going to lose a spell? Yeah, just our spells. We don't care about that. Hallowed Drippings, Fortify, and Resin Removal, which is a fantastic card. Fortify, hopefully we get the I forget the name of it. It's kind of like a shield slam, except like you basically deal damage based on your armor value. And then Hallowed Drippings, which is apply 3 burnout to friendly burnout units. We get 2 of those, which is pretty good. Now, people have been criticizing my play with the Melting Remnant. They said that I'm not thinking about it from a burnout point of view. I need to adjust my thinking about burnout. It's more of a positive than a negative. That's going to be hard for me to do, but I'll try. So, Tempered Talisman or Traitor's Quill. Both of these are kind of, they're okay, I guess. I'm going to go with Traitor's Quill because this could be beneficial later on. The +3 magic power, we don't have any. I mean, this is not a spell casting. Well, we got torches, but we have a lot of consume cards. Well, we only have 2 consume cards now that I think about it. All right. Having +5 global damage attached to torches, I'll bite. We'll try it. I usually would go for the quill, though. We have Rector Flicker or the Dark Calling Rector Flicker, which is going to be the one that reforms a random unit. Now, I'm going to go Burn Bright here because of the presence of the Hallowed Drippings. So, Burn Bright, I'm not necessarily going to put him down on the first round. I might. But we'll see. The last time I tried playing with Burn Bright, it didn't work out so well. It is nice for the 60-60, but you have to keep him alive. All right. So I think here we're going to go Rector Flicker, Greg. I want to try to keep him alive. He's going to end up killing himself on the spikes. So let's put one more Fortify there. There we go. And then I'll put another Dreg up here just in case the Collector goes up there. So if you don't know how Burnout works, Burnout is the mechanic of the Remnant, and essentially they have a time limit on their HP. Once they burn out completely, they're gone. But they can be resurrected by way of a mechanic called Reform or Reform. And that's where Rector Flicker, that's where the other one comes in. But I'm hoping that we end up getting... We end up getting a little bit more health other than just 2 Hallowed Drippings. So I'm gonna spend that now, and we have a +5 now, or +3 on the burnout. And then this global damage here, we do that. And we're going to take out the Collector. Yeah, we can take that out as well. Okay, Reeve Respite. I'm going to go ahead for Hallowed Drippings again. And I'm going to put two drags behind him. That should be it for the boss. Yeah, then we can go resin removal just for fun. Hey, you know what? Put another drag there. So the problem of burnout, really, it really starts to show whenever you're on bosses, though, because all your burnout units will only last for that many rounds. And once they're done, they're done. It doesn't matter what their HP is at. We have Wicklash, I should say, Draft, and Molten Encasement. Now, again, we don't have anything that gives us reform yet, so... You know, I think that Wicklash is probably good because it's a reusable burnout, and it also gives us plus 5 damage. Which we can use on our champion over and over again. Welder Helper, Fledgling Imp, or Ritual of Battle. I always like the Welder Helper. All right, here we are on the second map, and we've got Merchant of Magic or Merchant of Steel with a Heckhorned Banner. This one's tough because we have two really good choices here. I think we gotta go... You know what? I'm going... This is not wise. You should almost always go for the banner. But with the merchant, well, what do we have on the next floor? We do have a merchant banner and another banner. Okay, so what I'm going to do is, in that case, I will go for the Merchant of Steel this time around, since we have a Merchant of Magic coming up next turn. And we get Demon Fiend, which is again one of if not my favorite unit. We can upgrade him with Quick. And then the Heartstone as well. Although I would like to get... We could get Multi-Strike on him. But making him beefier is not necessarily a bad thing. Or I could use it and put it on a Train Steward. We do got some beef here. I'll go for the beefy demon. And then Wickstone... I'm gonna save the gold. Let's purge one of our train stewards. Sorry, train stewards. I know. A lot of people really love their train stewards, but I gotta save a little bit of money. Okay, we get additional unit drafter and non-boss enemy units get plus 4. I'm gonna go ahead and skip that because we have another banner coming up, and it's gonna be the Melting Remnant banner. So we didn't get a burnout card now, but I'm still going to put him down because we can take out you. And then the train steward, I'm going to put on the top row. Although I don't know if we get a collector this time around. Okay, unfortunately we didn't get the, didn't go the way that I wanted him to. Do that. We get the collector. He's resin removal. And we got to go burnout here, so let's go with the dreg behind, and let's go for Hallow Drippings. He's dead no matter what. Wicklash for sure. Another Hallow Drippings. And yeah, you know what? Let's get a Train Steward out there too. Take you out so there's no spikes. Yeah, we got everything. Good. Nice, straightforward. No problem. There it is, molded. Get on in there. Now we have the option to let enemies or to let our units expire, and then we can reform them and then really give them some major buffs here. Piercing 8 is fantastic. I'm gonna go Horn Break. Okay, now we're going to go for the Merchant of Magic. There it is. Keepstone is exactly what I wanted. We can put that on Molded and then lower the mana cost. Ember cost. Or we could go Whiplash to keep on doing that. But honestly, I think putting it on molded is really good, because that allows us to always reform a unit immediately, and the unit comes back stronger, and it also gets a zero cost. So I'm gonna go with molded. I'm gonna lower the cost on that. So now that's completely inconsequential for us to play. I'll get 18 damage on piercing as well, which is so good. Lady of the House and Paraffin Thug. You know what? Give me Paraffin Thug. I know that we want beef here, but the Paraffin Thug, or the Paraffin, I'm not sure how you would say that. Getting 20 gold is nice, but remember, we have molded, and as soon as I draw molded, we're going to be able to use it every single turn, so we can let him die a couple times. Okay, so this is the purge event that we were talking about, and this is the one that a lot of people told me I need to be using. It's not; it's just meant for a temporary payoff. Increase the magic power by 20 and add purge, or we can make a unit super buff for one round. I'm gonna put that on Train Steward. Put on the Train Steward. And then what we'll do is we'll use him against Daedalus. All right, so we got the explosions twice, which is pretty bad. I don't care if he dies here. Yeah, we didn't draw reform. I should say reform. I want the champion to go down once. I'll put the Paraffin Thug here. Okay, so the Rector Flicker is going to burn out, which is exactly what we want. Might as well get damage on Daedalus here. I'm not going to use Hallowed Drippings yet. So we should get Reform now. And we did. Or Molded, not Reform. Okay, so now what we do first, we got to take out the bomb. These guys have haste. Probably should have actually gone for him. But it's too late for that. So we're going to use Molded. We'll get Rector back. And we'll put him here. Now again, we don't care if he dies, because we're always going to have Molded. The problem is that we're not going to be able to get to the hasted unit, and that's a big deal, because they're going to go straight up to the top after this. But if we get a torch, then we can just take him out. We didn't get torch, although we did get Hornbreak. Okay, so let's take out the one that deals damage. Well, the most damage anyway. And we can use Molded to get a Dreg out here. Honestly, I think that we should just hold on to... We should hold on to Rector now. There's no need to get greedy there. Yeah, we get our damage on Daedalus. And he makes it up there. Okay, so he's about to burn out. Let's stop him from doing that. Daedalus is minus 420. We add another Dreg here. And put you behind that one. And then we'll go armor. To give him one extra hit. There we go. Good. Alright, so the molded holdover combo is working out so far. Memento Mori's real good, but it's super duper expensive, man. We can't take Dark Deal. I'll take Memento Mori just because it's synonymous with this clan. Lady of the Reformed is really, really good. She's really beefy and tanky. And here we got to go for Fell's Remorse because I want to get the big beef demon in. Okay, duplicate and a banner or heal our pyre. I think we want duplicate here because I want to have two holdovers on Molded. Consumer of Crowns. I mean, Consumer of Crowns is fantastic, but we only have one imp card. So it's not realistic for us to take him, unfortunately. And then let's remove the train stewards. Okay. Harvest plus 5 HP or burn bright 2. We're just going to go full on burn bright, I guess. Enemy units enter with armor 15 for 150 gold. Let's do it. I think we can do it. Okay, Rector, get out there. I could put Lady of the Reformed right here to add burnout to Rector, but we want him to kind of get a little bit beefier. I guess we don't have to do that. We got to take out the Haster, though. What? We didn't... Oh, that's right. They have armor. Yeah, that's right. Well, that's a problem. Well, let's take out the collector anyway. I mean, we're gonna suffer 8 damage, but not the greatest, but whatever. Give her a little bit of armor. Give her a little bit of help. Put a drag here. Yeah, the haster's got to get taken care of. There. All right, haster gone. We did get molded, so here we go. Well, one of our two moldeds anyway. Put you there. Got the thug here, which I'll put over here. Wow. That armor really kind of screwed us here a little bit. Okay, there's the double holdover. First off, I guess that's an enchantment, then? Interesting. Okay, we got a drag, but unfortunately this one's in the way. Let's put you here. Put you here. Extend the burnout. Yeah, there's Memento Mori. Which is still not enough to kill this guy. We have our 4 burnout. I'm going to put you down here. Put you here. Give her armor. Alright, we took a little bit more damage than I wanted to, but the boss is dead. So not the best floor there. The armor wasn't worth the 29 damage on the pyre, especially since we haven't healed yet, but what can you do? Engulfed in smoke, mortal entrapment, or the Voltivari. Get 28 damage and apply Daze 2. It's such an expensive spell, man. I do like the idea of card draw. And then ascend a unit for Tiresome Climb. Okay. Begrudgingly, I think we've got a heal here. We took more damage than I was intending. I could try to get a holdover for Memento Mori and drop the count. Or the cost, I should say. Yeah, let's try that. Let's lower the cost of Memento Mori. I sincerely doubt we'll find another Keepstone. Dude, 28 damage piercing is not bad at all. A double stack, which is not what we wanted, but I mean we can use it for Whiplash or with Fortify. Using an Tiresome Climb is also not terrible. I like that idea. Let's do that. Okay, so we did a little bit of splurging. Start getting rid of our torches because they aren't really making that much of a difference. Unstable Vortex. I think we're good to get rid of more of our torches. Maybe a dreg, maybe. I don't want to get rid of too many units. I'll get rid of one dreg. Okay, so we have Calcified Ember, which is really good to get the upgraded version later. It gives you one Ember and an immediate card draw. Go for Remove the Rubble. This is kind of a risk here because we are looking at a trimmed deck. But let's see if it works out. Spell Shield. I mean, we don't care about Spell Shield. Because we've got all physical damage, basically, except for Hornbreak. I'm going to go ahead and pass on that one. There he is. Get the big chunk in there. He's a big chonker. Go Calcified Ember just to get it out of our deck right now. Good idea. I don't care about extending the burnout right now, so. Okay, Memento Mori is good. Well, actually, it's not good right now. Wow, we did no damage to this dude. Okay, he's going to burn out. That's good. Let's extend his burnout. Well, no, because we've got holdover on the unmolded. Let's extend your burnout for a little bit. I That one hurt. That one hurt a lot. All right, Rector, get back in there, son. Get you up here. Use the other molded just so we have it. The holdover. I can't believe that we're not getting any damage on these guys. I mean, we have to. Gotta do that. Well, we didn't have enough people dying here. Yeah, we're at 12. We're at 12. It's okay. I think we'll go down to 3 if we don't kill him. Get the dreg. He's going to burn out, but that's okay. We can get Rector back. Next turn. That lifesteal is a pain. Rector, welcome back. Get on in there, son. Make a big time play. Yeah. All right, you know, just 3 HP on the 3 HP on the pyre. It's all right. We like to live dangerously. Memories of the Melted. Gain 1 ember for every friendly unit death this battle. Mortal Entrapment again, or Sacred Wicks. And I don't know about this one. Memories of the Melted is useful. It's useful for if we have a high turnover rate on our cards. Mortal Entrapment, I do like the card, but it doesn't work. The Dazed 2 is great, but we already have Dazed. We already have Dazed 4, so I think it's too redundant for me to hold on to that. I mean, yeah, this is just a skip. We absolutely have to heal here. We want to even have a chance. Emberstone. We can lower that to a 1 cost. Really, really hoping that we were going to get a holdover. Wishful thinking. Wicklash. That resin removal being free. Oh boy, this is gonna be interesting. This is going to be interesting. I'll be shocked if we get past this. We got pretty much the worst fell because of this freaking scourge, so I can't even put down Demon Fiend here. We need to get him down though. I'm gonna have to eat the damage here. This fell is precisely like the ultimate counter to what we've got right now. Like, look at this. We got a drag. We don't need to use Hallow Drippings yet. I think we can actually just use it down here. We can't. I mean, Rector Flicker can't die, so. He can die, but we cannot allow him to die. Okay, Memento Mori. Get our dregs back. I'm gonna hold on to the drippings for now. Yeah, then we can get her back. If we use Daze for... to move you up. Pyre should be able to take care of him. There we go. We gotta get creative here. God, these are so terrible. Keeping up with our dregs, though. I'm gonna take 13 damage here. Final wave for Fel. We need our big drag here. I think this is where we end. Welcome back, Rector. Oh, we can't fit him there. Hey, you get out of here. Memento Mori. Yes, we did it. How did we do that? We actually beat Fel. Woo. Enhance friendly units with plus 3x attack and 1 burnout. Devourer of Death is so good. Gain 1 soul. Extinguish deals damage equal to the number of soul to 15 times the soul's count. But Harvest is on this floor, so he has to be on the floor that we're going to go. That we're going to have a lot of turnover. And I think we go Light of Seraph so we can just stack the dregs. Damn the Ember! I think we only kept one. And again, we just have to heal here. Just hope for the best. We gotta heal. We're on life support, but we're still okay. We don't really have any good purge targets, to be honest. I mean, one of the fortifies, I guess. I mean, we're not using Wicklash at all. I think that the Fortify can go. Wicklash could potentially save a Burnout unit. I'm going to get rid of both of the Fortifies. I don't think that they belong here. They're counterintuitive to the whole idea of us reforming anyway, so. Then we can copy a card here. We can copy Demon Fiend. That would give us some extra beef. We could copy Memento Mori. I think copying another Molded is pretty silly. Could also copy Excavated Amber. You know what? I like the sound of that. Alright. Well, I didn't think we were going to get here. I didn't think we were going to get this far here. But, can we make a comeback? Guy's like, arr! We're just gonna stack them. Just stack them down here. Let's just stack all the things down here. We're gonna play Molded just to have it. Why did I put you there? I can't put the Devourer of Death anywhere. Yes. Okay, Pyre should be okay. 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, he's dead. Start getting our dregs back out. We're gonna lose the Devourer, and that's fine. Hey, what are we gonna lose you to? Oh, he extinguishes 5. That's not good. Well, I mean, getting the thug back isn't the worst thing in the world. Okay, Rector's gonna burn out. That's fine. Okay, Rector's gone, but don't worry, he'll be back. I think we gotta put Devourer of Death down there as well. But what do we do up here? What do we do up here? Memento Mori. Great top deck. Unfortunately. Man, that daze up there is killing us. We can't do anything about him. We cannot do anything about him. He's gonna get 30 damage on the pyre. That's not good. Really not good. Now I'm getting this is my comeuppance for getting rid of all those torches. Do we even know how many souls does he have? I probably shouldn't be putting him in the front. Because the front he's not able to get souls. I just thought about that. Put you in the back. That's where I should have been putting you. We gotta beat the horde here. Oh, we can't. I mean, resin removal is not going to do anything. I don't know, man. I think we might be. I think losing that 30 HP on the core was it for us. There's no way that we can stop these two. That really stinks that we didn't get our ascension back. But what can you do? That's why I don't play Melting Remnant, because I'm not good with them. So it was a noble chance. We only had one. There's no way we're gonna be able to take down the horde. Losing that 33 HP or whatever we lost to it early in that round was the killer there. So, but hey, we got a little bit of Melting Remnant level, and we got to unlock some more cards. And I beat Dodger at least. That's good. So anyway, thank you for watching, everyone. Hope you enjoyed it. If you did, click the like button. If you didn't, click the dislike button. Again, I'm not scrubbing any of the bad runs from this week since it's all random. Hopefully you are still enjoying it. And I promise you, we're gonna get a winning run here on YouTube. And or I'll just win more covenants offline. We'll see. So again, thank you all very much for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. And as always, I will see you all next time. Until then, so long, everybody.